Alrighty. Welcome to the stream, everybody. Hope you all doing well. Today, I'm back with more 2K24, my career. Obviously, as you can see by the title. And now by the screen, so. Usually, I would be on the practice court, or at least in, like, my court or something. But the Pacers, which was the current team that I was on, was being the keyword there. They decided to trade us to Boston. And as you can see, last time I played was on the 22nd, which I didn't play on the 22nd. I was trying something out, or I was seeing something on this one. But before I left, or yesterday, not last night yesterday, but the last time I played, which would have been Friday, I think I hopped on Sunday or Monday night, one of those two, and I was ready to play the 20th game of the season for the Pacers, and I didn't play the game. It, like, kicked me out. And it took me to this screen where it's like the what's new, the seasons, whatever. And I go to play next game because I was wondering what happened. And I go to play next game and my season's all changed up. And then I look down and I see that the Pacers played the 20 games. But then I start putting two and two together. I'm on the Celtics now, apparently. So, which, when I saw that, it made me not want to play that night, because, you know, you go through 19 games with the team, and you're doing fine, you're cruising, and then you just get traded to a team that is now fighting to regain a top spot in their conference, so. Which, to add salt to the injury even more, is the Pacers won their 20th game, which really kind of just made it worse. Like, they could have just lost that first game without me, but because I would have played against, let's see here, Pacers are over here. Oh yeah, so, because I would have played against Milwaukee on the 6th, and I was going to play that game, that was what I was planning on, but then it just kicked me, I don't know how to explain it, but it didn't load it for me, it just kind of like went to a black screen for like a second, and then it went to the how you first go into my career with the what's new, the seasons, whatever. But they did really well, and I guess me and Porzingis just basically got traded straight up for each other. Which now, I can still control minutes and everything, which is, thank God, I was able to get my 38 minutes back, because I think they had me at like 32 or something on the Celtics coming in. But you know, I'm going to be playing that 38 minutes. I'm a third year all-star right now. So, but I mean, the Celtics don't have a bad team. Definitely not what it is currently here in 24-25. And I'm in fucking, if we just go to player stats real quick, we look at me, we're in, yeah, 25-26. So, we're a year ahead. Because for the current NBA season, we're starting this 24-25 season, but I am a year ahead. So, but yeah. So if we look at the roster, we still have Jaylen Brown, which he's on a 4-year, $238 million. Jesus. So it looks like Jaylen Brown's my new, what you call it, my new duo instead of Halliburton. We got OG Anunoby as a solid third. Isaac Okoro, nice little wing there. Jordan Walsh, he's doing all right. Moore, and then that's where it kind of just... And Keita, I would say, and JD Davison, that's... We got Sam Hauser, okay. So, yeah, definitely not the roster that I'm used to with the Pacers. Because we had Haliburton, we had Maxey, we had Mathurin, Nesmith, Trey Mann, Jackson. And I can't help Mr. Oscar Shibuy try to win Rookie of the Year anymore. He is now by himself on that. Like, this lineup, I was ready to go to the playoffs with this lineup, with this roster. And they just decided to trade me to Boston for whatever reason. So I have not played since Sunday, I think. Saturday or Sunday. So it's been a little bit, I really didn't want to play a game just because I want to get first reactions of this lineup on stream and see how bad it truly is going to be. I don't think it's going to be terrible just because we have a decent starting lineup, with Keita, Anunoby, JB, and myself. But the highest rated second overall is Jaylen Brown as an 89. If we go over to the Pacers, I had at least Haliburton to rely on with being a 96. Maxey was an 88, but I at least had two or three solid options. They could hit a shot if they were wide open. I think if we go to my... I think I have to go to team stats or player stats. Player stats, probably. Where the fuck is it? No, I think it's... Team stats, maybe? Maybe. See, we're sitting 12 out of 30 teams, which isn't terrible, but... Can I not see my contract? What the fuck? Oh, where do I go to see everybody's contracts? I don't remember. Recent game shot chart, hot zones, attributes, plus stats, that's all stats. Where the fuck do I go to see my... Maybe I have to play a game, I don't know. Well, I was able to see everybody else's, that's why I'm like confused right now. I have no idea. I am confused. Where do I see my contract? I have no idea. Alright, well... That's out of the way. We are on this team now. I'm going to get a couple more shots up just since I haven't played in a week. Roughly. I mean, right now we're looking good. I mean, we'll get plenty. I think we'll get some shots during the game, so. Alright. Get one more shot and then we'll get going with games. But like I said, I didn't want to play a game just because I wanted to get first reactions with this team, and I didn't really feel like playing on a new team just in the middle of the week, so. After this, though, if I don't get traded again for some reason, I will try to get as far as I can throughout the week. Unfortunately, the Celtics are not playing on Christmas this year. If I wish they just traded me after Christmas, we could have had back-to-back years playing on Christmas, and it would have been nice. I think it would have been all 3 years we would have played on Christmas, but they just had to trade me. Yeah, I don't know how far I'm going to make it this week, but hopefully I can get relatively far. Right now we're fighting to make that top spot again, so we're already down 10 games. Let's see how far we can take the Celtics against Charlotte. We're at Charlotte. Green and white, why not? Man, that sucks.
Hey, it's Floki 5000 from the My Team community. My highlight of NBA 2K20.
I do not care.
Kick back, get your popcorn ready. We'll be back in just a moment.
Number one. Gotta rebuild team chemistry now.
Welcome everyone. Thanks for tuning
in. I feel like this is almost, this is absolutely worse than just requesting the trade. Because, like, gamer, yo, what's going on? You just missed my whole spiel. That's this is absolutely worse than requesting a trade. Because, like, with requesting a trade, and if they did trade me, then I knew I was going to have to rebuild team chemistry. But now I absolutely have to rebuild team chemistry, and I've got 60 games to do it. So that's... Nick Smith Jr. I'm guarding, right? Yeah, alright. Alright, first game on the Celtics, and we lose. We lose the jump ball. That works, that's fine. Okay. Now here's Smith. Woohoo! We got a foul first 10 seconds. Let's go.
That's his first foul. That was a
quick foul. Yeah, remember when I said you just missed my whole spiel? I got traded. That's just, yeah.
And out of bounds.
All right, well, this game is off to an exciting start. 13 seconds in, there's already been a foul and a turnover.
LaMelo Ball. What's really impressed me is his ability to create for others on the offensive end.
I don't know why I'm coughing all of a sudden. I was just fine.
He's put it to use, helping his
teammates. All right, JB, let's see what you got, buddy.
Here's Brown.
Hold up. And misses it.
They get it back.
That's that shit out, bro. You got center on you.
Here's Bay. Ball outside. Now here's Richards. Pass to Bay. Buries it down low.
No, I didn't ask for the trade. And if you remember, I think it was a week or two ago, I said in one of those streams that I was going to stay on the Pacers as long as I could.
Now here's Kaminsky.
Because I was happy where I was at with them. Well, good start. Got the assist there.
MP is always looking to get his teammates involved.
I don't think I would be this mad if I asked for a trade.
Ball outside. Pass to Miller.
Here's that should have been a steal. Shit.
This one for three. Tries again.
Good defense there, boys.
Oh, nice D from Ananobi.
I'm taking this. Damn it.
MP inside, covered by Smith.
My whole flow is messed up now since the middle of the season. And
ball against Ananobi. Here's Smith.
That's mine. Damn.
Second attempt to go. Now he's one for two.
My whole flow's messed up right now. I don't know. Fuck.
Kaminsky outside.
Ooh, good find inside.
than just a typical unselfish play from MP. He's got a really strong team mentality to his game.
This isn't even the first time, after my first season with the Lakers, I tried to resign with them, but I was fucking around too much trying to figure out the contract system. And then they didn't want to resign me because I was asking too much. And so I signed with the Pacers, and now this is my third year on a third team, so.
Smith with it. Ball outside.
If I play 10 years, I might as well be on 10 different teams, right?
Richards with it. And right now he's currently
that better be on Brandon Miller. Yes, sir.
Let's see some of the numbers here for LaMelo Ball.
Well, the league has put an emphasis to crack down on illegal screens.
Like, I don't know why the Pacers traded me. Like, I just gave them a ring, gave them an 81-1 record last year.
Stationary on those
screens.
Get
the fuck out of my way.
Hips or elbows.
And then this year we start off 19-0 with me. Like, there was no point to trade me. They got Kristaps Porzingis out of it, which, I mean, I feel like I would be worth much more of a trade than that. Like, an actual superstar. Kristaps Porzingis is an all-star, but, like, they could have just traded me for, like, an actual superstar there instead.
That gives them the lead.
Really confident play there by him.
You know what I mean? Like,
and then
just
goes right into a shot.
Charlotte trailing.
Because now I don't know where my contracts are going to be set up with the other team, with the other, like, with Nike and all them.
Takes a three.
Because I don't know what I'm going to be able to get. I don't know if I'm going to be able to hit 50, my 50 points, 15 assists, and my triple-double and all that. So, like,
that's a terrific answer there.
Now here's
assists seem to be just fine, but it's my pass points I'm worried about right now. Ah, JB, damn.
He's one for three.
You know, sometimes
like, I'm
making it
kind of excited to play with Jaylen Brown, but at the same time, I'm not, because I was doing just fine on the Pacers.
As the official calls the foul, he'll shoot one more at the line. And you don't see many 6-7.
And like, I already spent the entire season with the Pacers last year. I was ready for this season. I was gonna grind this season out, get another championship, get all of the Hall of Fame stuff complete, and now in our first game we're not doing great together because fucking team chemistry.
What stands out most to you?
Well, I like his length. He's a rangy point guard, but it's how dynamic he is, BA.
And because team chemistry's fucked up, they're not making the passes I'm wanting. So my percentage is going
to
go fucking hell.
Smith. Kaminsky pulls it in. Boston's gone one for
everything's just going downhill.
Covered by Smith. Oh, a clear foul there on the missed shot. At the line, it's going to be on Nick Richards.
Hey, if you can't block it, sending him to the line can be the next best thing.
Yeah, exactly.
Give him a little ball. Well, I would say if you can make it past your third or fourth year and you've proven that you can win them championships, I would say, yeah, you're pretty much stuck there. But for me, it was only my first year. That was my second year in Indiana, so, like, I get why they would trade me, but now, since we're in the same conference, it's going to be really fun to beat them every time we face off to prove to them that they shouldn't have traded me.
Smith passes to Richards.
That's my steal. That's cookies. Yes, sir. Get that corner. Don't want it. Pull up. Yes, sir.
After a cagey pass fake. He's got six.
Gotta fight harder to get over those screens. Well, I'm gonna credit the screen. I mean, that's a good, strong.
That cancels the assist. Perfect.
To the paint.
Out of my way, LaMelo.
Back to ball.
Damn, that's insane.
Ball throws it down.
Well, it's great seeing.
It's another thing. Just Halliburton being 6'7", 6'7", 6'7", 6'8". Like, he was able to make plays on the defensive end because he was tall. And on the offensive end, he could see stuff a lot better. The rebound. Now I got this fucking 6'2" guy as my point guard. Like, against this opponent, they secured the win because their second unit really stepped up. And you know what? It just be crazy. Like they did in
that one. I'd expect to see plenty of minutes again for the guys coming off the bench. Brown,
and it's good off the back. I mean, we seem to be playing well, but got a second basket. I don't know. Some, it's just off. It.
That's what they need to do. Yeah, these teams trading punches right now. I mean, it's table tennis. Back and forth we go.
Here's Miller. In his last outing, 16 points for him.
And what build is that? I don't know what build you have on the Lakers. I don't remember what team you have with what build.
Pounded by Ball. Pass to MP.
Cut. Thank you. And one.
And he was fouled while in the act of shooting, so he'll take two free throws.
Jerry Smith, Bill,
Now one on Ball. And let's take a moment here to get your take, guys, on the scoring so far for the Hornets.
To me, it's been the ball move. That's been the key. I mean, going from good to great. Not settling for a good shot, making that extra pass, keeping the defense off balance, and taking great shots.
And the other thing you notice is how determined they've been to get into the paint buckets around the rim.
Both teams will make substitutions. I'm going to apologize in advance for the rest of the stream. I was fine literally 10 minutes before I started stream.
Answer both.
And now I am just hacking up alone.
And so it's Ball with it. He brings it up for Charlotte. They trail by one. They come into this one following a loss to Brooklyn.
Yeah, we know that on the road, you're already a little out of your element. Then the misses from the line become contagious. And you know, one of the things about missing
Washington shooters, I thought for sure they were going to swing that to Smith.
But it allows the other team to maintain momentum or keep a rally going.
Pulls up on the wing. The Hornets pull it in.
Clean look from mid-range.
Thought our center was going to get that.
Damn. And the whistle on the shot. Got some contact there. Misses the shot, but he'll shoot two.
Second personal foul. And the third team foul. At the line.
First free throw is good. And the Hornets making a change here. DeRozan has checked in. A big group substitution here for Boston.
DeRozan on the Hornets. Interesting.
Both.
I thought he was on the Pacers. He was last year. Interesting. Okay.
Good from the line that time.
He's as solid as.
Alrighty. Start the second quarter.
Charlotte's gone 3 of 6 from deep so far. Sadiq Bey out there with Nick Richards.
We're going to be suffering these first two, these first couple of games.
For the Hornets. That puts him in the lead. Miller's got 6.
Until I build up enough chemistry, this is going to fucking suck. Why is Hauser at the 4? And Anobi should be at the 4.
Now the Hornets moving it up. The finish! Cuts off the pass.
I guess Ananobi is kind of a small forward. Ananobi, bro, thank you. Holy shit.
The long range hit from MP. And a chance to catch up on some numbers here. The hustle.
Yeah, those are going to go way down until I can get this team where I want it.
Everyone on this team continuing to jump at opportunities to come away with steals.
One other factor today, points off turnovers. I mean, let's see if they can keep up the pressure. Capitalize off more forced miscues.
The Celtics with the lead. Just over a minute gone here in the second quarter.
There's no reason to ignore the pass. I'm open. Give me the 3, dog.
Now MP. He has 6.
Oh, thank God.
Stolen by Bay. And here's Ball. Here's Miller for 3. And it's MP with a rebound.
Now Ananobi wants to be at the 4. Jesus.
Ananobi against Bay.
Yeah, might as well pass it to the person you know.
Now it's a 3-point Boston lead.
He's somebody that's really comfortable.
Oh, man.
Ball taking his time here.
That's my board.
Good D by MP. Boston has got 4 of 7 threes to go so far in this game. And he drops in the layup off the glass. He's got 12.
Guys, I tell you what, feels like everything is coming easy to him. Just taking what he sees and capitalizing.
Miller, the pass to Ball. Here's Miller. Over MP.
That's good, D. It's good contest.
For Boston, they've gone 3 of 3 to begin the second. Here's Hauser.
Oh, Hauser, bitch.
Second chance effort.
No foul there, ref?
For Charlotte, they've gotten only 1 of 4 shots.
Well, I wouldn't even been able. I wouldn't have complained it to the ref if fucking Hauser just passed me the ball there. Someone cut. Nobody wants to cut there.
To hear from Allie LaForce.
The Celtics are battle-tested and asked what comes from that experience.
There you go, Watts.
Poise. Being able to see and read the game.
Points right now is my biggest concern, because right now assists and rebounds are dropping, but...
And just letting the game decide.
Yeah, that's been the key. Thanks, Alex.
We only have 2 shots. We're 2 for 5.
Timeout called by Charlotte. All right, Grant, I'm going to ask you... Tell us what the key is to establishing culture in an NBA.
I just need them to actually pass me the ball right now. Structured accountability. Ananobi took 7 years to pass me the ball in the three for my second one. Then Hauser didn't even pass me the ball. He forced up a bullshit shot.
Jaylen Brown, he's checked in for Hauser. MP, the pass to Keita.
Oh, Keita. Come on, bro.
Here's Miller. He's guarded by Kaminsky.
I'm there. Always shoot that.
Cool, nice shot by Miller.
I always think I'm closer to him than I really am. So I think I'm going to be able to get the contest, and then I don't. What are you doing, bro?
Back to Brown. To the inside.
Pass it out. Double screen, no.
Clock at 6. It's blocked. Here's Ball. He's coming off a 19-point game against Brooklyn.
And his assist numbers were remarkable as well. His play is crucial to this team's success.
Yep.
Boy, you've got to appreciate the passing there. Results.
Boy.
The Celtics have gotten 4 of their first 9 shots to go here in the second.
Bro, take the screen. Take the screen. Come on. Fucking hell, guys. Jesus.
Hounded by Ball. 18 feet out. And he hits the jumper for 2. He's got 16.
And he's coming off a huge performance, and his confidence couldn't be any higher. And his coach knows that, too.
Showing no signs of slowing or cooling down. They're going to ride him as far as he can take him.
Thanks for stepping over there, Watson. Give a little help defense.
Completely in the zone this quarter.
The Celtics have gone 5-10 in the second quarter.
No, stop going back. Take the screen and actually go the way. Fuck, dude.
Another one falls for Boston.
And he can take over in a nanosecond. I mean, once he catches fire, it's difficult to squelch it.
Now here's Richards.
Why would I want new teammates? I have to rebuild team chemistry.
Fires the 3. Bay, no good. And so Brown will bring it up for Boston. They lead by 4. Their next game, playing at home as the Pacers come to town. And that's the first of just 2 home games for them.
When I have to rebuild team chemistry, we're fucking trash. Everything's janky with
Brown
plays. Oh, fuck.
3-pointer, no good.
Given his range,
like with the Pacers, I was started off 19-0 with them.
Ananobi against Ball. Inside.
If you're happy on your team, there is no good thing about being traded.
Kaminsky's got his 7th rebound of the game with that last one. To the middle.
All right, they're starting to pass me the ball a little bit.
Giving the people exactly what they want. MP with an attack on the rim.
Technically not middle of the season, more like a quarter, but
11 points in the game.
I felt like with me on the Pacers, we were basically postseason ready. Like, 3 seconds, 3 seconds, 3 seconds. Thank you.
And it's going to be a 3 second call. The league is already buzzing.
Yeah, and just out of nowhere,
likely to make an appearance.
19 games in, and I just get traded for whatever reason.
As long range shooting continues to be a coveted talent in the league, but these guys are in a league all their own. You look at MP, he occupies the top spot in voting. We'll very likely see him in the three-point shooting competition.
Extreme cable,
and he might already be the favorite. When he gets in a groove, he's automatic. And as we continue to count the votes, we'll update you on any changes to the list.
No, I mean, if I can at least keep good averages, if I can get the triple-double with maybe 30-40 in my first few games here with the Celtics, I should be fine.
Here's Miller. His scoring ability is impressive, averaging 20 a game. There's Ball.
That's
the
insane.
Hits a three-pointer. Ball's got 8 points.
You know, if LaMelo shoots it at a high clip from deep, man, oh man, I don't know how anybody's going to guard it.
Oh, that's his eighth make of the game. He's only missed four so far. Great timing and coordination.
Watts is a rookie. Okay. Starting rookie. That's good. So we could still make a run for helping a rookie win Rookie of the Year.
Kaminsky outside.
Come on, fucking hell.
Takes a 13-footer. Cash. It's MP picking up the assist. And it's a 7-point Celtic lead.
Brown has a nice shot repertoire. Clearly the mid-range doesn't give him much trouble.
Richards, the pass to Ball. Ball in the paint. And once more this half, they find a way to get great position inside. Pounded by Ball. And here's MP from outside. It's rebounded by Charlotte.
You know, it hasn't been his best outing, but they still find themselves in the driver's seat here.
Pass to Richards. To the left wing. Here's Miller, covered by MP. Yep,
that's insane.
Timeout. And now just a 3-point Celtic lead.
Gotta fight harder to get over those screens.
Well, I had the help to get over the screen. It was called my center, but he just let Brandon Miller go right past him.
Washington's checked in for Charlotte. Smith comes in for Bay. And now let's see who is leading the league in steals. MP, number one.
And no surprise he's at the top of this list. His aggressiveness and opportunistic attitude on defense helps this team so much.
Boston has gone 1-4 from three-point land here in the second. Davison, the pass to Kaminsky. To the inside.
Oh, boy. Okoro, let's see what you got for me. I like that. I like that. I like that. Okay.
Assist goes to MP. MP's got assist number 8 here.
Wasn't able to play with the bench squad in the first quarter since I already got 2 quick fouls. So let's see how we can see what we can do with them here in the second quarter.
He's guarded by Kaminsky. Elbow shot. And again, it's Charlotte converting. Here's Davison. Pass to Kaminsky.
Thank you for going right back to where I was.
Inside from 8 feet. Here's Okoro.
Okoro.
Here's Miller. 13 points in the game.
How do you foul? Just put your hand up.
The NBA for fewest turnovers per game. They do a pretty solid job protecting the ball on the dribble and making smart passes. And you look at their rim protection overall. It's the quick rotation and help that separates them from some other teams. And he drops a first. DeRozan has checked in for Charlotte. So he gets them both.
Boston has gone 2 of 5 from distance here in the second quarter. And Davison, pass to
Kuzma. There we go. There's one.
Celtics, another three.
See if we can get something going here late first half. Hopefully we can carry that into the second half. We've missed three threes, which isn't terrible. Not the worst we've done, but
144 left in the second period.
Back to ball. Well, we've double-digit points now, so
and looks like an illegal pick was set.
We got a good start.
Now a moment to take a look at the year-to-year scoring output and how it's been trending for DeMar DeRozan.
Thank you for the hydrate, gamer.
It seems like other teams have figured him out.
All right, JD, here we go.
He's having to put
see if
we
can get me something here. Nope, Melo stuck by. Damn.
Davison can't hit.
A little hesitant. Maybe he thought the D was tighter on him than it really was.
Here's Smith. Here's Miller.
Straight up. Good shot contest. We'll take it. All right, minute left. We got takeover. Here we go.
But they're still losing.
Oh yeah.
Kicks it out to MP.
Oh yeah, there we go. Bang.
Another three.
As the deep shots
continue, I'm liking. We're starting to get some passes to us again now.
Among these defenders. Yeah, and they either have been unwilling or unable to take that shot away.
The three from Washington. And there's the
yeah, that better be a foul. I'm going to push him in the back.
That's his first foul of the game.
All right, less than a minute. See if we can get another assist, maybe a few more shots up. Maybe getting two more shots up at most here. Nope. Get JD right back in the screen with me. I like that. I like that. I don't like that though. Kick that out. Get out of the paint. Get out of the paint.
Back to MP.
Let's get a Okoro up here. 6 seconds. Might have to pull up. Now we got time. We got time. Bang! Utilizing all 24 seconds.
You can't afford to let him get to the rim that easily.
Well, that might be why their deficit is what it is right now.
All right. Two or 3 second shot clock differential. Nobody's up at PJ. Muddy missed. Okay, we got 10 seconds. Here we go. Let's get a Okoro here in the screen again. If he's open, I'm passing it to him. I'm passing that shit to the lane. Bang! There's 10 assists, double-double.
MP's always looking for a teammate to set up like
that's good. That's good defense to end that first half. There we go.
And so it's Boston.
Okay, we got a three. We got two assists.
Their defense is forced
to I'm starting to feel it a little bit here in Boston with this second group, with this bench squad. With Okoro and Davis. I'm feeling a little something. Just need to get it with the other starting four right now. Right now, we're good. 4 for 7. We got 8 threes to spare for the second half. We have a triple-double somehow. What the hell? Well, we got the triple-double in the first half. That's amazing news. So we don't have to worry about that. I just need 5 more assists, and I need a bunch of points here. Yes, I do play shooting guard. Jaylen Brown plays the he starts the three now that I'm here in Boston. But he seems more like a LeBron where, see, he's bringing the ball up a little bit more.
They've got Jaylen Brown, also OG Anunoby out there.
And I mean, Watts is a pretty good rookie right now, so.
Now here's Kaminsky.
Oh, I'm liking that, Kata.
Outside, Brown. 6 on the shot clock.
I'm just going to get for rebound position.
From the wing, Richards pulls it in. Well, the Hornets shooting the ball at 48% so far.
Stay there, stay there. Why would we switch that?
Kata pulls it in.
Why would, Watts, why would you want to guard Bay, bro? Right there, Watts, you had me, dog.
And he sinks the layup. 22 points for him.
How about that wonderful floater he has?
I'm going to try to score as much as I can. I need 50 for contract. If I could get 50 here in our first game together, I know I'm going to be chilling. But I need 36 points. That's 17 or 18 a quarter. 36, that's 18 a quarter. We can get 18 a quarter, but it's gonna be pretty tough.
MP loves a good three-point duel. Ball passes to Richards. Now Bay. Oh, and he got fouled on his way up. He'll head to the line to shoot two.
I would say maybe if we can get to 30 here by the end of the third, potentially. Might have a chance for 50. We do still have to sit for like 5-ish minutes.
Hits both from the stripe.
So that's also going to be a factor that's going to come into play at some point.
Pass to MP. And Anobi with it. Back to Kaminsky.
There we go. Add Nick Smith in, bro. Fucking pass that shit inside. I'll go up for an easy layup.
Throws good. Kaminsky.
At the line. Two shots.
And that one goes.
All right. We're starting to get something rolling here.
And now around 2 minutes gone by in this half.
Just need to keep it going. Keep it going.
Now here's Bay. Here he goes.
Damn.
He lays it up and banks it in. Bay's got
tough bucket there.
If you give him any sort of
had a nice move. Just got
attack.
Clear lane to the rim.
Now MP.
Easy layup for Watts. There we go. Bro, what? What overall is Paris Watts? Homie's a 76 overall as a rookie. And they got him in the second round? Shit. Okay, well, if the Celtics can keep both of us, Watts and myself, that duo's gonna look pretty deadly here next few years.
And that one drops for him. And just totally
I don't know why the Pacers trade me. I can kind of see why they traded me. They needed a big man, like a solid veteran big man, which they did get out of Kristaps Porzingis.
11 rebounds in the game. Nice rebound.
But they had two solid young guys with Dylan Douglas and Oscar Shibui, which were, I'm assuming, just the CPU generated rookies. I don't know if they're in college or if they're real players. But like, you had those two young guys, and Shibui was he was solid defensively, and so was Douglas. Obviously, Douglas had his moments, but they had two big men right there. I don't know why they traded for like a veteran type.
Inside.
But that is definitely why they traded me away, so they could have that veteran center. It just sucks that I happen to be the guy to go. Unfortunately, Halliburton was the untouchable, and they didn't really have... They could have traded both big men with Oscar Shibley and Porzingis, but I don't think the Celtics would have taken the trade if they did that.
Five of six shots to fall so far in the third.
So, sucks that I was the one that got chosen to be traded straight up for Porzingis, but it is what it is, I guess, since I couldn't do anything about it. I couldn't say no, unfortunately. But okay, we need to get something going here. We got 21 points, which isn't bad, but
gives us a chance to catch up with Ali LaForce.
Well, LaMelo Ball's shooting touch was questioned coming into the league, but it's been pretty steady.
Come on, let's take the screen. There you go. Pass that shit back. Pass it back. Young age,
I feel every shot I take is going to go in, and my confidence
Watts
is
got
really high.
28.
So I practice these shots. It's all in the snap of the wrist and the follow through. Brian?
Ooh, very interesting. A flick of the wrist. Thanks, Ali. Good stuff. Now here's Ball.
I'm there. That's cookies. That's cookies. That's cookies.
Here's Brown.
There we go.
Boston scoring again.
Okay, I
now we get a little perspective here on how the hustle now, game has been for the Celtics.
You have to be a fan of the NBA. I gotta somehow become the star of this team to where I'm able to get my 50 points. Damn!
A few times for them. You know something else, guys? You know they came out of that tunnel sprinting in a full
right now only 20 points
sprint
in the third quarter. This to the floor not looking good.
In the fast break game.
I mean, we've still got time. We still need to sit for about 5-ish minutes.
Here's Smith. He's got 17.
We're not hitting 50 today.
And it's MP with a rebound.
You have to I still need to get assists as well.
Amazing job on the glass.
That's so stupid.
A well-rounded performance. I mean, strong rebounding has certainly been at the center of it, but it's been good on a number of levels. And the basket by Gooden.
I need four more assists. I'm gonna have to I don't think I can renegotiate my contracts to get me lower points. I can get the VC I want. Come on, JB, take the fucking screen, dude. Holy shit. How many screens I gotta fucking set for your bitch ass?
Five on the clock.
You know what, for that you can force the shot up. That works.
Boston with the triple. And you know, we've seen Brown accept more responsibility over time on offense, including taking these quick shots. Now here's Bay.
That's cookies again. There we go. I'm so slow.
Up the floor.
There we go.
The bucket is good and he'll go to
get the steal, reward the man for him.
Since halftime,
for it.
They have been efficient and effective, making coach very happy. Boy, I like the disposition and attitude since halftime.
And I'm moving to the one. Interesting.
Washington's checked in for Charlotte.
Okay.
Rosen comes in for Bay.
I'm the point guard now.
The Hornets have gotten only 4 of 10 shots to fall so far in the third.
We need 3 more assists. That's on me. But he still missed it. That's insane.
Kaminsky's got 13 rebounds in the game. Glass eating.
Oh my gosh, I can't just call a screen now. I have to actually call plays. Fuck.
Now here's Kaminsky.
That's why I don't like being point guard. Because I can't just call for a screen. I have to fucking...
Okoro's got 10 points. Gotta fight harder to get over those screens. Well, I'm gonna credit the screen. I mean, that's a good, strong pick he lays there. Pass to DeRozan. Smith with it. Down to 5 on the shot clock. Give me that. And it's blocked by Irving.
And right get that
now,
up to JB.
Category. That's helping them run away with this. Yeah, double-digit advantage on the scoreboard. They've taken the initiative. They've played, I think, with more purpose so far.
Well, yeah.
Now here's Smith.
I don't know why that wouldn't be like that.
Oh, it's been a turbulent quarter, really rough for him. Nothing
just being fucking 26 forever in your prime, like.
Brown passes to Okoro.
Yeah, it is. It's just common sense why it would, you know, go up each year, because
he's putting them to the test this quarter, attacking every chance he gets. Now a timeout called by Charlotte. They've been committing a lot of turnovers, and
I think it would be a lot cooler if your guy didn't age, because then you could just stay in the league for 70 years. Like,
the Celtics making a switch here.
It would make breaking records a lot easier.
And now in December, here's what the Eastern Conference standings look like.
We're 9.5 games back. So 10, we're 10 games back.
To make a move in the standings. And of course, Charlotte.
Okay, we're back to the two guard. Perfect.
Well, right now for Boston, they're just inching their way toward the top of the standings. They're one of the early successes of this season. I'm not sure how long they'll be able to stick around up there, but so far it's been a lot of fun to see how much progress they're making. DeRozan passes to Washington. Over Irving.
I'm gonna try to do all that I can to make sure that my team does not lose.
And you know they've got to be careful because this is when the team concept breaks down and guys start playing hero ball.
God damn, Okoro! All you had to do was take a dribble and then just pass it back to me, dog.
To the paint. Here's Gooden.
to halt the run.
That's insane.
Good work defensively by Kaminsky. Here's Okoro.
Good pass. Irving finishes it with the and one. There we go.
2 points and a chance for one more at the line.
Okay.
Want to score in the NBA?
Okay.
Picks can really force the D to make tough choices.
Moore's checked in for Boston. That free throw good from
I just need another game or two after this one, and we should get enough team chemistry. We should be chilling.
That's taking care of business, fellas.
Here's Gooden. Pass to Smith.
It may take more than just two or three games, but all I need is about 75%, and then we're good. I feel like that would be enough just for me to cruise with the Celtics here this season.
Here's Davison. The Hornets pull it in. And following this one, they'll take on the Hawks in Atlanta. And that'll be their only game on the road before heading back home. Here's Smith.
Good block there, Moore.
Here's Davison to the middle.
Why would you pass that, bro? If you're gonna pass that, make sure to go down to like the corner or something. Let them get set up in the post. Shit. Irving sent me screen here.
On the wing, MP. Pass to Davison. Back to MP. Here's Okoro. Four on the clock. Kaminsky outside.
Pass. Okay, we got the. We got the one.
10 for 15 now.
Guys, this has been an incredible performance.
There we go. I mean, he's getting the ball where. Now we're starting to get it rolling. Now we're starting to get going. The and one off the three. Shit. I didn't even green that shit either, bro. Shot clock was running down. I was just getting a shot up. I was half expecting to just miss the shot and get ready to go back on defense. Then we got fouled. I was ready for three free throws. And then we made it and get the and one. I'll take it.
Smith passes to Washington.
That puts us up to what? 31 now? That's good. We can get a few more points here in the second, in this third quarter, the last 2 minutes, that was trying to say. We should be looking good.
And here is Kaminsky. Back to Okoro.
Damn.
Ooh, he's locked in. Drains his fifth shot in his many attempts.
Still need three assists. It's been tough because, like, every possession I've been trying to get points for me. And, like, I don't know. That's good defense. That's my. That's not my rebound. That's fine.
Because of their efforts on the glass.
Yeah, rebounding has been a big key in this one. They've asserted their will and have taken control on the glass.
Screen for Davidson here. Come on, take the screen, dog. Take the screen.
Pass to Moore.
Ah, good play. That's good two-man game there.
Solid play all the way around.
And trust me, when the D's slow to react, he'll be the first guy.
Got a minute left.
Boy, the defense looks shell-shocked. I mean,
see if we can get an assist or at least one more bucket.
Now here's Smith. He's got 17. Here's Washington.
Good block.
Oh, and he blocks it off the glass. Wow.
He's been ice cold tonight. And you know, you look at the scoreboard, guys, they really could have used his contribution.
Come on.
Pass to Moore. Here's Okoro, defended by DeRozan.
Nobody's taking my screen.
Kaminsky, the pass to Moore. Over Washington.
There we go. He gets it.
Look, and it's on target. Moore's got 4 points.
Should be an assist for us. It is.
And just shredding apart.
Oh, that's cookies. Yes, sir.
He's helping to pace this offense so well.
You know, Moore's right there. Go up, big man. Go up. Out of blue, big fella. Get the steal and get another assist. We'll take it.
That's 3 buckets in a row off assist. Charlotte has gone 1 of 2.
All right, that should put us up to 14 assists now. We're at 31, so we need 19 points.
Smith with it.
19 points and an assist here in this fourth quarter, but we still need to sit for a few minutes.
And the officials.
Thank you. Thank you.
The screener was leaning a bit right there. His feet may not have been planted. Pretty obvious call by the.
We're getting subbed out. Nope, we are just at the one. Okay.
Call for the refs to make, but not that time. It was easy there.
Oh, Hauser, we'll take it. He's stepping into that.
Oh. Good on the buzzer.
I wanted to pass it to Okoro on the wing, but I forgot he got moved to the two. It's all good, all good. Solid third quarter. We'll take it. We got a beautiful third quarter.
All right, let's take a look at our assist of the game presented by State Farm.
We almost had an alley-oop assist, but team chemistry not quite there yet for it.
Yeah, that's just a brilliant read.
Ooh, to me.
Defense. I mean, it was also excellent anticipation of the movement of his teammates before the pass.
All right, I'm going to check box score real quick. Go third quarter. We had 17 points, so we almost got the 18 points that we needed. That's good. 5 rebounds, 4 assists. We had 3 steals in that quarter. Shit. That's our best quarter. That's arguably one of our better quarters just in our career so far.
Alright,
7 minutes. Need assist and 19 points. It's going to be tough.
Rebound Boston.
We can do it, but it's going to be tough. Come on, take the screen. Hauser, take the screen.
Then it's Smith. And it's Ball in at the one. So that's the group out there for Charlotte. Pass to Davison.
Take the screen, Hauser. Go over. Gets the shot off. That's wow.
With time running down on the shot clock.
Peep these handles, folks. A spin move like that is how you shake the nearest defender up for good.
Here's Ball.
That's insane.
He's 6 for 12 from the floor.
Hey, Ball has tremendous confidence, oozing with confidence. He feels like he can cross up anybody defending him.
There we go. No, too late, bro.
Oh, you look at the size of the contract.
Nah, damn it.
Clark, you wish you could still lace him up?
Hey, it's all relative, BA. Guys that played way before me probably felt the same way about the money we were making in the mid-80s, so... It's relative, but it is quite astronomical. But it is
take the actual fucking screen. Keep going. No, stop spinning in the same fucking place.
Other income from ticket sales and the like, and that number is humongous, and the players deserve a significant portion.
Thank you, Hauser. Fuck.
The math, as crazy as it looks, still works.
Wow. What can you say?
Ball passes to Richards. Here's Miller. Pass to DeRozan. Oh, trying his luck from deep. Rebounded by Davison. Davison's got his fifth rebound.
Damn it.
And out of bounds, the Hornets will take it.
Okay, if you're going to make me be bumped and go back with that type of animation, fucking hell.
And it's DeRozan with the ball for the Hornets. To the inside.
Thank you for letting me get stuck on my own teammate.
On the assist by Ball. Smith's got 19 points.
Swear to God, Davis. Take the fucking screen and move. Fuck me. God damn it.
Richards pulls it in. Richards has got 7 rebounds in the game. To the paint. DeRozan. Can't cash it in from close range. Boston has gone 2 of 4 from the perimeter here in the fourth quarter. Down low.
There we go.
Kaminsky slams it home.
Well, there's no denying.
I don't think we're going to get 50.
And this type of performance serves as a testament to his work ethic.
Inside. Richards, the pass to Miller. Smith against MP. The three is up. Smith, that one's good.
And Richards had our guy fucking boxed out instead, so.
He's putting on a commanding performance here. He's hit 2 3-pointers in each half now.
Kicks it out to MP.
Shooting that, I don't care. Right. God. Okay, it's fine. Mid 3.
Been pretty simple here in the second half. Attack from 3-point range.
Certainly. I mean, they saw a weakness in the perimeter defense and took advantage of
it. And the Hornets making it.
All considering, yeah, I am having a pretty good game.
7 for 15 in the fourth. DeRozan passes to Gooden, and the layup is good off.
Considering I only had like 5% team chemistry coming in.
Great vision.
11 points. It is still doable if Davis stopped just dribbling in the same fucking place.
To the inside.
Davison.
Damn.
And another dime for him. That makes four.
I know Tatum got traded this season too. This current season that I'm in.
All game long. Ball passes to Miller.
I don't know how spacing would work with me, Tatum, and Brown. I don't know if Tatum would play the four, JB would play the three, and then I would play the two. That's how it would, how I would assume that's how it would work with us three, but I don't know. Definitely an interesting thought to see how that would have worked with us, with JT and JB. But yeah, it's whatever. Okay, pass that shit up. Pass that shit up. Thank you. There we go. Okay. 9 points, 3 minutes. How many? That's all we need. 9 points in 3 minutes.
And here's ball.
We can do it. We can do it. We just need teammates to just don't fuck up. Just don't have our teammates fuck up. That's all we need.
Here's Gooden. He's guarded by Kaminsky.
Damn, that's insane.
After a nice bounce off the right iron. Gooden's gotten
okay, I'm going to get takeover here.
He's really carrying
JD,
the load,
I swear to God.
No man can do it all by himself. Davison, the pass to Kaminsky. Here's Hauser. Kicks it to Kaminsky.
Yes, there we go. There's one. 6 points. Come on. Come on, baby. Oh, shit. That's 10,000 career points as well. Come on. 6 points.
Here's good. Second chance shot. Kaminsky pulls it.
I'm giving it to Hauser. I don't. He's going to give it to Davison.
Kaminsky's got rebound number 17, if you can believe that.
Hauser, keep the ball. Nope. Hauser, keep the ball. Set the screen. Take it, yes, sir. Ah, oh, they don't leave me though.
Here's Hauser, defended by DeRozan. Good on the shot.
Minute 40. We need 6 points.
Failing to box out. Ugh.
Those are free points you're giving away. You gotta work harder on the glass.
That better be on Davison. That is okay. They're in the bonus.
Didn't give him any choice but to blow the whistle. I mean, you gotta play without fouling.
At the line.
I could try to get JT back, yeah. I would have to see what everybody's contracts is. See what kind of salary we could get. Or with salary cap and all that. It sucks because I don't have as much control as, like, my team kind of thing. So I can't be like, oh yeah, we'll try to give you as much money as you want, but you might need to take a little less, but because like JB and JT don't need fucking $500 million contracts. Okay, take it, yes sir. I'm taking the three, I don't care. Damn it.
The disparity in the talent was obvious by the end. Sometimes you just don't have.
I need 6 points. If I made one more three, it would have been.
And the next time these teams meet, I can't imagine it'll be any different.
And this will push their total wins for the year up to 11. And
they've now. There we go. Okay, come on. 4 points. 4 points.
They're playing with a lot of confidence against Charlotte.
And of all the highlights and performances we've seen here tonight, the one thing that stands out is what an unbelievable.
50 seconds. Come on. Come on, Hornets. Shoot it. Come on, DeRozan. Shoot that shit. Shoot it. Shoot it. Thank you. And my guy got boxed out, but we get the board. Pass it up, Davidson. Davidson, you bitch. Okay, we got it. We got it. Was that two or three? That's the three. We need one more point.
Kaminsky's got 49 in the game.
Come on. Come on.
Stepping up and nailing an important shot to put this away.
That was that not a steal? 8,000, that's okay. Clock stop, clock stop. We have one possession here.
Go get it.
We have one possession here for us.
Yeah, if you're gonna foul, then make sure that
we've got the 15 assists for that contract. We need one more point. DeRozan's got two free throws, needs one more.
Has that old school game, a throwback wing. He's not just a 3-point shot.
He missed it. He missed it. Pass it up. Pass it up. Pass it up.
Kind of matchup.
Davison, thank you. We got 50 points, baby.
They really came in with the right mindset today. I can guarantee you their flight home will be filled.
The one pass I needed Davison to make. He actually passed it to me. The fans are already headed for the good defense. We out, we out. Gonna try to get one more here.
Davison, hounded by ball.
Nope. All right.
So we see the
we got 51, but that's all we needed. We just needed 50.
A performance like that, that says a lot about this squad.
They really came in looking confident and didn't let anything shake them. This is what a dominant team looks like.
Well, folks, that's going to do it for now.
I mean, we don't need the 50 points, but it just helps. We're up to 45% on team chemistry. Thank God. So that means one more game here with the Celtics, and we should be having absolutely no problem. So now if we go to 45% with team chemistry, wins are, okay, next, we play the Pacers. That is, well, good thing I got traded then, because it's going to be definitely an interesting game here. We're starting to ramp up with, our own Celtics, and let's see how Porzingis does with the Pacers. They won their first game by like 15 or 20 points, but Quest. I think I can go to mine now, right? I can go back to my court. Yeah, I have to go back to my court and do those. I have to do those quests on because I was looking at my takeover and like the minimizer takeover perk, it's alright. When somebody's closely guarded with their takeover, if I'm closely guarding them, it doesn't last as long. But I'm trying to get the accelerator takeover perk. Takeover meters fill faster when performing well on the court. Meaning it allows me to get takeover quicker. So that's what I'm trying to go for, which means that's why I have to do those quests. But I'm going to do those off camera, since those are not truly my career, I guess. I don't know. How much VC do I have? I have 107,000, basically. So I've been playing my team off camera, so I'm trying to save up some VC for that. But, yeah. Okay, last game, not bad. 51, 17, 15, and 4. God, I hope our teammates can help us out with more of that. Let's see, Paris Watts is only 6'1", shit. Okay, why, we have two 6'6 players playing the 2 and the 3, and then we have a 6'7 playing our 4. I guess Kata does make up for the size being 7 foot, but and our backup 4, backup 5 are pretty tall as well, so I mean, they got, we got decent size off the bench, but starting lineup, eh. Now that that explains why Ananobi is playing the 3 at some points, because he is more of a 3 small forward build. Alright, Halliburton, Isaac Davis. Oh yeah, who is our coach? Isaac Davis is their coach, which going to assume that Michael West was the one that traded me, which they've just currently made a rival for themselves. We move and we stay in the 12th spot because the Celtics have one more game on them. Game played, okay. Our coach is Logan Schmidt. Interesting, okay. Okay, can I see what the fucking There it is, the contract. Now I can see the contract. So I am still just a core player on this roster organization then. Still not untouchable. JB's untouchable, and I think he might be the only untouchable. Everybody else might be expendable. Brendan Jordan is a prospect. Where was, where the fuck is, Watts? Watts is expendable, even as a rookie. We signed him to a 2-year, 18 mil, damn. Oh, they might talk about it. Let's see, Davison is expendable. He does have a no-trade clause, though. Hauser's cap space, that's disrespectful. Jesus. I'm $35 million a year. And I gotta rebuild my bird years again for the next contract, but... well, thankfully, and hopefully here, if I can stay on the Celtics until the end of my current contract, I will be on the Celtics for 3 years. That gives me my bird years / bird rights, and I can take a much better contract. but JB is on a 4-year, $240 million. He doesn't have a no trade clause, but he is untouchable, so it's going to be very, very tough to get him out of here if we want him out. But right now, I need another superstar, and JB is the only one we got. And Anobi, I'll take him as an all star. So, all right, I'm going to go to team practice just to see if the team chemistry can go up just a little bit more before the game. I'm not expecting much, but any little bit helps, really.
Hey, man.
Gonna go over here and shoot with Hauser for a little bit. I think they need to redesign their fucking practice facility. There's just so much green. I don't understand what the... I don't know whose idea was it to make this, like, mint green. Just the outline for everything. Like... whoever they are, they need to be fired. Alright, let's get an interview real quick. See if that helps. I know it's gonna give us a few fans, but... oh, now I want to talk. You know, I was just walking around them. How many fans we make? How many fans we get off that interview? 500? Yeah, nothing. Compared to what? How many fans we have currently? That's nothing. Okay, what kind of contract is what's his face on? Jason Tatum. Bro, they're 13-7 right now. They have Ime Udoka as their head coach. Shit. JT's playing the four. So. JB, if we do get Tatum back, which I don't think is going to happen, he's averaging 27-7. Yeah, he's not coming back. Let's see, what's his contract? I can't see his contract from there. I think I have to go to roster. Can I just not see everybody else's contract? He's on a 3-year 150. Which would be... I don't know how much money. I don't know how much money that is a year. Can I only see my own team's contract? Okay, where the hell did I see it? Where the fuck did I... Okay, am I just dumb? Where the fuck did I go to see that? It wasn't team stats, I was just there. Okay, where the fuck did I go to see this? Not minutes. Was it minutes? No. Where the fuck did I... It was roster, wasn't it? I'm so confused. Where do I go to see my contract? Okay, I'm looking this up. Ah, shit. Where can I see my contract in my career? 2K24. In the current roster view. So it's the roster. I was there. Okay, roster. Then we go through here. Where the fuck is the contract? I have no idea. I don't know how I was able to see it, and now I'm just not able to see it. Like, what the fuck? Is it because I'm, like, in practice? What happens if we go to the fucking, the neighborhood? Or if we just leave here? Use the directory, just go to my court, whatever. Well, we see that Tatum's on a 3-year, $150 million contract, which I don't... We're going to have to make Jaylen Brown take a hell of a discount if we want to re-sign him. If we want to re-sign all three. Okay, I guess I just can't see it while I'm in, like, the fucking practice area. That's stupid. Okay, what is our team's salary cap? Go team stats. Lineup stats, strength, schedule, team stats. Last season, we have 172 million. So 35 plus 9, 44. Our rivals are New York, so. Let's see, 44 and 54. So that'd be 58, 98. 116, 119, 120, 131, 141, 150, 158, 160, 60, 163, 164, 165, 169, 171, 174. Yeah, there's no way we're re-signing Tatum unless both of them take a hell of a pay cut. 'Cause JB is the only one with bird years. So he's able to go over the salary cap, which we're at like 174, and our salary cap is 172. We're probably at like 175, 176 with all of like the point 94, whatever, because I just rounded to the nearest whole number. But I mean, yeah, I could still try and get him, but all I can do is just influence a trade, like, hey, we should get Jason Tatum back, like, but there's also the fact that I kind of want to run the team, and right now I think they have Paris Watts and JB running the team, because fucking Watts just put up a career high with 28 points. He had 26 against Brooklyn. He fucking 20 points. I mean, he's a rookie, so, and if he's going to put up at least 15 points a game, hell yeah, I would build around that. Like, but let's see. Options. Influence trade. And that's another thing. It's just influencing trade. So if I do go for Jason Tatum, they would probably just swap JT for JB straight up. But and he also has a player option with a no trade clause, and he's untouchable, so I think he may have just re-signed that 3-year deal for New York. So yeah, that's probably not gonna happen, to get him back with a no trade clause and him being untouchable in New York. That sucks. He probably had a no-trade clause. I think he just re-signed. I think he just signed with New York, unfortunately. But yeah, it's whatever. I mean, right now, I'm just trying to rebuild team chemistry. And so maybe before All-Star break, I can influence some trades, see if we can ask for somebody else. Maybe like another decent big man behind Keita, or even to replace Keita and just move Keita to the bench or something like that. Yeah, I don't know. But we are in Boston against Indiana. Let's see. Let's do it. Gonna go white and green. Here we go.
We have had so much fun on 2K24, and the fun will continue all summer long. Make sure to look out for us.
Oh, my jaw just popped. Shit. My jaw just popped, and now it's like I can feel it move every time I move it like side to side slightly. Oh, that don't feel good. Oh, KP and the orange and blue, or the yellow and blue, damn. And joining us courtside, reporter, yeah, like when it felt like good, but now it just feels really weird. Oh shit. Wait, do they have Maxi starting still? Do they have Maxi starting now? And it's Maxi in at the two spot. Maxi's starting now. Okay. Then it's Kaminsky. From backup point guard to the starting two guard. Wondered how long does it take for a team to gel, especially if they've had big off-season roster changes. All right, Maxi, bring it. Come on, Keita. Atta boy. All right, here we go. Start off strong here. Start off strong. Halliburton ain't got shit on me. You know, Halliburton, we could have ran for multiple championships. But now we're enemies. Maxi, I could have gotten you 4 more rings off the bench, buddy. You could have been 6th man of the year. But no, you just had to trade for Porzingis. I don't know why I'm getting mad at the players like it was their fault I got traded. Oh, Watt still gets there? And he gets it to go. That's on the defense there when MPC
senses one of his guys is open, he hits him right away.
You could go, you could do a Bill Russell and just win them fucking double digit rings and not leave, just be a loyal Laker. That's insane.
He just makes it look so,
let's see,
easy on offense.
Can I see here? I can see their latest game, yeah. Their recent, that's his recent games. I need, yeah, somebody. So they haven't played since the 6th. So they're still 20-0. We got to make them their, we got to have them as our first, as they got to have us as their first loss of the season. Bro, Watts is popping off to start. Three shots, three attempts.
Willing to challenge the shot. Lots of
fucking three shots, three attempts, same thing. But he's on, he's already 2 for 3, so.
First quarter of play with about a minute and a half gone.
All right. Well, look at what we got, Pacers. What we got? Halliburton shooting that. He's missing that. That's my board, yes, sir. Get that up early to JB. All right, come on, Celtics. We got to put our differences aside, and we got to win against the Pacers here. We have to win against this team. I don't care what it takes. Ah, shit.
Indiana's gone 0-2 from deep here. Maxi on the wing. Over MP.
Damn straight. That's good defense. Take the screen, Watts. Take the screen.
He's covered by Halliburton.
Come back for the screen. Come back. Yes, sir. I'm liking that. I like that. Drive that on him. Ah, damn it, Watts.
Off the mark. Excellent defense there from Halliburton.
That's cookies. That's cookies. I got you up.
And a fast break now for the Celtics.
Gets fouled. There we go.
On that shot. The Celtics shooting their first free.
See, I'm turning the anger I had last game, and I'm turning it into revenge in the second game here.
First one falls for.
See, we already played the Celtics. I think we played the Celtics twice. We blew them out.
And you remember it well.
Yeah, you're talking. So now I think we have one or two more games after this. We have this one, and I don't know if we have one more. I don't know if we play these guys one more time after this. But if it's not, then we better play good for this one. Good D, that's my rebound as well. Someone cut to the left. JB should have cut to the left. Got Ananobi in the paint. Yes, sir. Dean Wade too slow to catch up on defense. He must annihilate them.
As soon as he has a step on you, it's over. Here's Maxey. Taking a look at his stats, he's averaging around 9.5 points a game. Here's Halliburton.
Got KP boxed out. Yes, sir. Good rebound there, Kato.
In their last game.
And you gotta love a team that can maintain its composure.
Give me a screen here.
On the road. Take good shots.
Right there. Good pass. Oh, and Ananobi from the free throw line. That's easy money. There we go.
They never let the fans become a factor.
And it just seems that every pass they make is leading to a score. Just great ball movement.
I'm here, Kato. I'm here. Good switch. Good rotate, I should say, not switch. Damn. It's all good. Good defense there. Good
defense.
Okay, we need to get some shots up. But, I mean, we do have 3 boards and 3 assists. So, like,
under 80 from the line, I'll bet he'd like to get that up over that mark.
No good on the free throw.
First one, okay. So far, no trade talk about me and KP, so I mean. Alright, makes the second one.
And at 7-3, Porzingis could have been just another big, but he defies expectations. He's got such
JB, top of key. Damn.
Array of abilities.
Now, here's Brown, and Ananobi now top of the key.
Oh, guys, come on. You're making the paint too congested. He misses that. That's wild. Someone cut. Kata's there. Kind of, not really.
And too much time in the lane.
Kata, bro. Go to the short corner, my guy.
More games under our belt. The power ranking starting to take shape. You look at the Spurs. They've achieved some upward momentum, climbing to the fifth spot on the board.
And I think for the Celtics, they're kind of in a little bit of a holding pattern early on, trying to find answers to a few questions, but overall, playing a solid brand of basketball.
Now, here is Halliburton.
Good steal there, Kata. Made up for the turnover last time. Last possession. Oh, yeah. Bro, Ananobi's going to feast with Dean Wade when Dean Wade is in the game. Ananobi is going to feast with him there.
Keep it up. Their lead will only continue to grow.
Austin Mathurin.
Ah, shit. Ananobi's there. Good defense, kid. Thank you for that help.
The activity he shows around the rim is why he is such a respected defender.
Yeah, you can see why established that reputation.
Bro, if Dean Wade gets switched onto you, we are feeding you all night long. He can hit the shot on offense, but his defense is where we are going to absolutely just take advantage of.
Maxi, no good.
And if they want to mount a comeback here, they need him to get going. It's just that simple.
Where's he at? Where's he at? Kata, come here. Okay. And he stays on Kata. Lovely.
His first shot coming late, and it's Boston with another.
Timeout. Every time they get scored on,
oh my gosh.
It's come from his
with me on the Pacers, we had enough rotation ability to make up for Dean Wade's lack of defense. But here, I am just gonna absolutely obliterate that advantage for us.
And if they can keep that same physicality, you have to think they'll be in a good position to grab another win here.
Now, here is Halliburton, still without a basket. Maxi kicks to Halliburton.
That should be easy defense.
That is his first foul of the game.
Damn it, OG. That's all good. That's only like our second or third foul, I think. In 6 minutes, we're chilling.
And so it's Indiana with it, trailing by 13. Halliburton for three.
Damn, that's good box out by us. We saw that shit a mile away. Porzingis.
Alright,
JB, you got Wade. Come on. I didn't get the screen just yet. As soon as Kata cuts, I'm there. I'm there, baby. Bang!
Giving up far too many.
That says your core. Probably not a superstar. I would say maybe in a year or two. But I'm at least an all-star. I should be an untouchable player at least.
Not really his best quarter as far as scoring. Let's see if he can eventually get back on track.
Watts, don't shoot that bullshit, bro.
It's rebounded by Indiana. They put up a nice win against the Bucks the last time out.
Yeah, and with most of the arena,
I don't think you can be an untouchable without being a superstar, though, on a team, unfortunately. But
make the right play.
Even with all that,
well, they finally get a bucket to go. That's insane.
Their offense was in tune like
good pass there, Watts. Good pass there.
Nobody around. And the Celtics hit again from deep.
So now we're getting it rolling. All we needed was one game with this team. Take that anger from game one, turn it into revenge on game two. They really should have traded me after this Boston Pacers game, because now I am making them pay for trading me. I'm going to go corner. JB's just going to shoot that shit. Good board there, Kata. I'm out. Ah, damn.
No good. So it's Porzingis. He'll bring it up for Indiana. Maxi with it. Picked up by Brown.
Ah, oh, JB, why would we switch that? I had him, bro.
Heads up on the money pass by Maxi. Great vision.
Watts passes to MP.
I should have gotten Ananobi in a screen, but that works. Nice little pull-up jumper for JB, so.
MP's got five assists in the game. Pacers trail by 16.
Oh, that should have been steal, but they call timeout. Okay.
In the NBA, but Jaylen Brown has many other interests outside of basketball.
16-point lead with 4 minutes left in here in the first. Isaac Davis probably looking over here right now, and he is pissed at his management.
Trying to find some answers.
I know they needed a big man, like an actual solid veteran center, but like, they didn't need that with me, bro. Give me 2 years with the two centers we had coming off the bench, and they would have been just as good. They would have been absolute beasts in the paint. Like, good block there.
They've been sensational on the backboard to start this game.
Good cut, Okoro. Nice pass there, JD.
Displaying intensity right off the opening tip, especially on the offensive end.
They came out swinging, really setting the tone on offense. And the
well, my Celtics teammates have definitely sent the message with me, which is absolutely fantastic. They read the playbook before this game. They knew what needed to be done.
And what stands out during this recent stretch is just how well they passed the basketball. I mean, this is a club that has become really
well,
unselfish.
Now looking just a game in,
and the first
with
one at the line is
me
well, we
basically setting the team up
20-0,
I've kind of set myself a challenge, which honestly is a good thing. Like, I've set up a challenge for myself to see if I can get the Celtics to the top seed here in the East. And now I have a bunch of reason to. That was a travel. I have a bunch of reason to because of the Pacers. They shouldn't have traded me, so now I've got my reason to go win a championship here with the Celtics.
To being a legal
just to spite
that's a
the Pacers.
Avoidable turnover. You gotta focus on the details.
Right now, we ain't doing too bad. Definitely a lot better than our first quarter last game. We actually have points here in the first quarter. More than just like just a couple points. We have we almost have double digit points, which is definitely a good start.
Passes it to Okoro.
Come on, Okoro, take the screen. Okay, that works. That technically taking the screen. Good steal there, Irving. Pass that right back. Ooh, gets the layup, but he misses it. Damn. Let's see, 50 divided by 4. We need just over. We need like 11 or 12 points a quarter just to get 50, which is definitely doable. I mean, I was able to get fucking 20, I think 20 points in fourth quarter last game. That's insane. Three of us there. We couldn't get the board the first time. Oh, I'm nobody in the paint except me. Oh, damn it.
Kaminsky misses.
And he did everything he
as soon as I said it, everybody just collapsed. I gave away my plan, damn it. Let's get it up to Okoro, see what he can do. See if we can get another bucket in the lane. No, damn it. Okoro ain't doing shit with it. And just as I say that.
Their play on both ends has been superb. We'll see if they can maintain the momentum.
I will say, having KP on the Pacers does let everybody else run their kind of normal positions. Like, you're able to see Maxey in the starting lineup again. You're seeing Christopher play the two on the bench. Like, you're seeing the players where they should have played without me. But with that, without me, yeah, just like you said, gamer, they're ass. Like without me, you're seeing the players play their true positions. But without me, they're also losing. So, pull up triple for Mathurin there. Interesting.
Some people could say he's struggling on offense this period. I like to think of more of drowning.
Oh, JD, shoot that thing. No way he misses that. No wonder he's on the bench. Damn! And that's our ball. That's insane.
And out of bounds as the Celtics gain possession.
I wonder what the rotation is. Like, when's Jackson gonna play? When's fucking Shibley and Douglas gonna play, you know?
Holding a big 18-point lead to close the quarter. And we'll see if they can keep up their tremendous shooting. They've been dialed in so far from the field.
Like, cause I had like a 12 or 13 man rotation, but I don't know what they have for rotation, cause Mathurin and Wade played the entire quarter. Not Wade, but Porzingis. They played the entire first quarter. So I wonder if Haliburton and Maxey are going to play more in the fourth quarter then. I'm moving forward. You're a bitch.
And if you're just tuning in, we've got a wide margin on the scoreboard, but plenty of time left for a comeback. In a moment here to take a look at some hustle stats for Boston.
I can't move forward like that. Like,
something else. Going after shooters and really hustling to get their hands on shots.
They've out-hustled the opponent so far.
Moving sideways. Call for a screen. Moving sideways. And pass it to him.
On the court for Indiana. Wade out there with Porzingis. Then it's Haliburton.
Attaboy Watts. No, damn.
It's Wong in at the two-guard spot. Pacers trail by 18. Pass to Porzingis. Over Moore. Nice shot by Porzingis. Porzingis has got
I can't move really without going forward somewhat, but I'm going to try my best. I can do that. I can set a screen and just stay where I'm at. That's not me moving. I can't control that because damn cutscene, whatever. Yeah, I got 4 more minutes of this. Let's see what we can do. I could be a real bitch and just call a timeout, but just wait a minute.
Three-pointer of their own.
And an eye for an eye. Both teams working to stretch the floor.
This is today's NBA.
Just stay where I'm at, and not going to count.
Often than not.
Now here's Moore. He had 10 points in the win against Charlotte.
And also active defensively.
And you can see him one, okay.
His overall floor game.
A moment now to see how the schedule is looking for the Indiana Pacers. On Saturday,
Magic and Sixers back-to-backs.
And the Orlando Magic.
And you know, nobody loves playing on the road, but it does offer a good chance to see exactly what your team is made of. This team is going to find out a lot about itself over the next stretch of games.
Well, I've scored, so
that's good from
doing better than I thought I would with no moving forward.
Are still in the league today. Does that affect your analysis of their
I would say you've really just kind of taken me out of defense since I can't move forward to like cut in front of people and all that.
Just kidding, Kev. All kidding aside, I respect all of these guys and I try and be as fair as possible.
He's perfect from the line this time. Pacers trail by
I can just steal the ball when he crosses over, if he crosses over.
What's the latest, David?
Hey guys, MP in the last time out against Charlotte just was phenomenal. He contributed 51 points.
Damn.
And that was only part of it. As he added
I can't move. I guess this is moving sideways really technically. If I just
really
go like zigzag.
Back to you guys.
Thanks, Dan.
Oh, I could have shot that. What am I doing?
The team really fed off his energy.
Yeah, the catalyst for that win, it was an
I was open. I could have shot it. Damn it.
Hoping to replicate tonight.
And it's very likely that he and his guys can carry that momentum into this one.
Now, here's Nesmith. He has yet to score. Basket good. Nesmith. Celtics leading by 16. Watts. He's covered by Haliburton. The pass to MP.
That's so stupid. And I fucking fouled. God damn it.
And the foul called on MP. That's his first foul. And the Celtics making a change here. Kate is checked in. Maxie's checked in.
That's only our first foul, yeah. So
for the Pacers.
And we're now shit. I wasn't even looking at the screen. God damn it.
And it's Halliburton missing.
And physically, there's no doubt they've been the stronger team. A plus 10 rebound advantage tells you all you need to know.
Here's Watts.
Why is Watts taking these bullshit shots?
Trail by 16. Maxie in the corner. That's good, and it's Halliburton with the assist. Maxie's got his first 3 points of the game.
That's on the D there. You gotta chase Maxie off the 3-point line.
And now the first timeout called here for Boston.
And team strategies closely guarded. One aspect of the game the fans aren't always privy to.
And we see it so often. One little tweak to the game plan and everything falls into place for a team.
Change here. Mathurin's checked in. Now we get a chance to check out the standings out east already. We are in December.
Alright, 5 minutes ago. No moving forward's done.
They lead the pack up front in the first spot with the best record. And of course, there's the Celtics. They're 5 spots away.
And I think for Boston, they're one of the NBA's early season success stories. They've made an immediate push toward the top of the standings.
I wish I could say I saw it coming, but I had no idea they put it together. So, a tremendous job by the
now we got to rebuild our momentum.
With the ball, he's covered by Brown. No one near Maxie as he lets it fly. Off the mark there with the 3-point shot.
Just an ugly show for him offensively. Yep, no way to describe it. Just ugly. And
thank you with the foul.
And the call on the shot that sends him to the line.
Oh, that's a really nice job from MP to invite the contact and then get to the line.
The Celtics shooting their 5th and 6th free throws of the game. Free throw good, MP. And both free throws good for MP.
Yeah, nice job of drawing the contact and creating opportunities at the line.
No, god damn it.
Hold on MP. That'll be his 2nd foul of the game.
That's his 2nd, and I think they'll keep him in, but he's got...
You know, he's dribbling right in front of me, and then when I swipe, he wants to turn. Makes sense.
Outside Mathurin. Here's Porzingis. Shooting foul as the whistle blows. He'll shoot 2 free throws.
At 7-3, Porzingis is almost impossible to guard, especially when he's focusing on trying to score. 2 shots.
And both free throws good for Porzingis. Boston leading by 13.
Come on, take the screen, Watts. Take this fucking screen. God damn it.
He dishes it to Kaminsky. Back to Brown. Good, and it's MP picking up the assist. MP's got his 7th assist in the game. Pass to Porzingis. Fade away, and he comes up
with
the news.
That's insane.
Porzingis has got 9.
Damn, he's already got 9. Shit.
Porzingis really is a unicorn.
Watts passes to MP. Nice ball.
Shoot that, Watts. Thank you. Bang!
Boston with the triple.
There we go.
Let's just say this hasn't been his quarter. Yeah, he's shooting 20% in it so far.
Bounce pass, Halliburton. Maxie looking it over.
It's good defense.
Rebound Boston. Kata's got 6 rebounds.
I said, "Oh, bro, damn."
They've been better.
God damn it, Watts.
And there is a glaring discrepancy between these two teams.
He could have passed it to either me or OG, and we could have gotten a dunk maybe.
And got there first.
But no, we want to take a charge.
Maxie against Kaminsky.
Ah, shit.
Right side, Porzingis.
Surprised they didn't pass it to Maxie there. Thankfully, they didn't.
Outside, Mathurin. 6 to shoot. Lets it go with a 3.
Okay, Kata, why am I the one boxing out Porzingis? I was on the opposite wing, dog. I passed that to Brown, but I guess not. Okay. Pass to Anunoby. Kicks it out to Anunoby. Come on, Anunoby. Back to Anunoby. There you go. Finally. We had way to max it. We had the mismatch, so might as well take advantage of that. I need to get points scored. Outside Mathurin. That's my board, yes, sir. Get that up to Anunoby. Right here, court. Oh, my gosh. Out, JB. Thank you. Oh, my God. Bang. Damn, straight Max didn't think he needed to guard me all the way out there. And the Pacers call time here. MV really making a difference here. He'll just keep hurting them from the three-point land if they let him. Here's a chance for coach to change that. Okay, what are we rocking with? 16-9-9-K.
Here's a look at the teams that have been dominant offensively over the course of the past month. Number one, the Pacers.
Yeah, I wonder who helped them get that 155 points a game. Yeah, because of that rhythm. Why did they trade that man? Such an interesting question for him. God damn it. Okay, JV. How are you going to let Mathurin out rebound you, bro? Thank you, Mr. Jaylen Brown. Making up for the last possession. We'll take it. Taken over this quarter. Keep feeding the beast. Maxey against Kaminsky. And damn. Not the good contest, but just couldn't make him miss. And he's turned it on here in the second. Here's Watts. The shot's good. Brown making the play.
Brown's got four assists in the game. The assist totals, Kevin, just continue to grow. They're way ahead in that category.
Shit.
Ball movement has been flawless.
No! Okay, whew.
Maxey, no good.
If they want to come back, he needs to be better.
Come on, get around him. Fuck.
Brown inside.
Good finish there, JB.
Makes it off the glass.
Muscling that one in. JB
me saw the... Oh, shit. I don't even know where I'm at. I think that's how you say it. Thanks for the follow. Appreciate that. We're there. Kata's there, but he can't block you for some reason. That makes sense. Oh, yeah. Pull up. Why did... Okay, never mind. Trust the process, I guess.
You thought that first quarter was good? He's been even better in the second.
Mathurin's, yeah, he's pulling that. No question. Gets the screens open. That's a catch and shoot fucking regular jump shot for him. He can hit that all day. Oh, JB, we could have hit him right back with a three of our own. Everything he could to make that shot as
difficult as possible. Excellent D, avoided fouling and got in perfect position to alter that shot.
Now, here's Wayne. Looking at his numbers, he's averaging about 6.5 points a game.
Ref! Illegal screen! Good block there. That's my board. Come on, who's running? Who's running? Kata's running on Wade. No! Oh, we got the rebound, though.
Passes it to MP.
Kata, go back to him. Come on. Kata, my guy.
A second chance effort.
Oh my God!
7'6" wingspan. Porzingis has always been a big time shot blocker.
And let's head over to the sideline and catch up with David Aldridge.
Thank you, Kevin. The Celtics are a powerhouse, but they also know they're going to get every team.
I'm
going to
lose my mind with this team.
Got to be ready. All-star Jaylen Brown says comfort will kill you. These teams aren't waiting.
You had. You have. Let's see. How tall is Dean Wade? He's like 6. He's 6'7". He's 6'9". But Kata, you're 7 foot. That's 3 inches. Post him up and take him to the rim, dog. Like,
you gotta go out and prove it every single night. success is earned.
And then not only did we get owned by Porzingis on the defensive end, he's now killing us on the offensive end.
David, you are in the Hall of Fame, my man. You have earned it. Thank you so much.
For real, bro, was scary, but I might get blocked by him. Like, Dean Wade is jumping that high.
What are we doing? Pacers trail by
16. I'm gonna punch each one of my teammates after the game in the locker room. How does he get the offensive board? You had the position. You had him. All you had to do was just put effort forward, man.
Davison, the pass to Hauser.
And Okoro's our three.
MV left side.
Okoro, please. Thank you. Fucking hell, man.
Okoro's got 8 points.
Oh, such a feel shot there, the floater.
The pass to Christopher. Over Kaminsky, and there are the Pacers with another bucket.
A nice move to create a gap there in the defense and get to the bucket.
Davison, the pass.
There we go. Good pass there, JD.
With the triple.
And this really is the story of the game. They've been outstanding from beyond the arc, especially in the second.
All right, we're getting 50. We've got 20, 24, I think. So now, in the second half, we still need to sit, though, for 10 minutes. But we don't need to focus on assists in the second half. We can just focus scoring. But we still need to get a couple of assists, but we don't need to get as many. Oh, give me that shit, boy! Oh, don't pass it to me. I got fucking Porzingis on me.
To Irving. MP outside.
All right, Coro, I'm going to need you to set a solid-ass screen. Thank you. No! I blew it. That's on me. He did what I asked him. That one was on me. I'm sorry, Coro. I blew the shot, bro. Oh, hell no. Oh, hell no. See how easy it is to guard them? Like,
inside.
Ooh, gets that pass inside. Swing. Swing it. Swing it. Shoot that. Shoot that. Thank you. Thank you. Atta boy.
Davison's got himself on the board with three there.
Last second. JD, what the fuck are you doing, bro? He's already at half court. Step up.
He was a true standout at the offensive end.
Ay, ay, ay.
And his passing will return shortly.
Oh, man, these guys. These Celtics, these Boston teammates, bro. '24, '12, and '11. Not bad. Could be doing worse. For sure could be doing worse.
Well, we've got a second.
Why do I have such generic shoes on there? Don't I have my signature shoes on? I don't have my signature shoes on. Shit. I just realized that. I've been hooping in generic ass shoes, bro. Get up there, JB. There you go.
That's the Boston Five.
Oh, if my guy didn't just swing back that much, I could have gotten the block and saved Kata from a foul. Damn.
Pacers have made 6 of their 7 attempts at the line in this one.
And they've had really good numbers all season from the free throw line.
Mathurin hits them both.
All right, JB. Come on. Take the screen. There you go. But don't pull up, dog. What are you doing?
Wade's got rebound number 5 here tonight. Porzingis trying to get free.
That's insane. Maxie tried that.
Celtics shooting 52% from the floor. Nice work so far from them.
Go Kata. Gotta switch this. Oh, that's too easy. How would you not slamming that shit down over Maxie, bro?
From over here, you can see. That one
Are you not dunking that to the fifth dimension on him? Coach, you really couldn't have just kept the trade the way it was? Even if you traded me, you couldn't have gave me Porzingis instead. You left me with a bunch of bums.
That free throw, no
good. Oh my god. Now I have to try to find... I have to wait until we get another decent center. We had decent centers in Indiana.
And here are the Pacers now. Trailing by
19. Oh my gosh.
Halliburton passes to Porzingis.
But no, we just have to trade me away. We have to trade our fucking championship god away.
Halliburton's got five
for whatever reason.
Saw the defender closing and Halliburton got it away.
Oh yes, sir, JB, good pass. Bang. There we go. Good start.
Slow to close out on those 3-point attempts.
I'm here. Kata's there, finally blocks. He blocks Maxey of all people. Like, you're blocking the smallest player on the floor. Even I can do that. Like, that's cookies. Don't pass it to Kata. Thank you. Just pull up. Yes, thank you. Holy shit.
It seems Brown keeps getting better at shooting the ball, especially from the mid.
Oh my god.
And the lack of rim protection top.
This team's going to make me lose my mind.
Coach is going to give them an earful about that. He can't be
like Kata. Yeah, he's a solid center. It's just, he's not the center that I'm wanting. It's like I never even left the Pacers, bro. Our fucking center sucked.
To halt the run.
No shot, I didn't block that. What? That's insane. Homie is shooting 4 for 18. Holy shit. Watts, you stupid motherfucker. Kata, you don't deserve the ball, bro. You've just disappointed me too much as an actual center, dog. Good board there. Come on, take the screen. Of course you're not going to take the screen from me. That's bullshit, dude. And doesn't get blocked. That's good. Bully ball right there, Watts. Bro, Watts is doing a better job at getting a layup off a big man than you are, Kata. Like, holy shit.
Now here's Porzingis, 14 points for him. Here's Mathurin.
Mathurin thinks he's the man.
Boston. Kaminsky with the ball. Halliburton picks him up.
And Anobi right there. Attaboy. At least get to the free throw line. Because I know that OG might be able to make both of them. Kata might be able to make just one of them. There we go. Yeah, you think the management's gonna see that? Like, hey, you know, the guy that we just traded for just made us lose our first game of the season and, you know, beat us by 20, 30 points. Maybe we made a mistake on that one, guys. Or this was the thought process. You know what? Oh, gee, you bitch. I gave faith in I had faith in you to make both of them.
They'll be hosting Orlando for the next one. That game will be a quick pit stop before hitting the road again.
But the thought process for the Pacers management was like, you know what, guys? We won a championship. We don't need to do anything more for our team. That's goaltending. What? Oh my god. Homie just sent this to the 17th row. My god. No shot that wasn't goaltending. He got it just before. God damn it, bro. Oh, man. All right, where did he send this thing? And oh, I thought I was gonna hit the woman's face. How did both of the Yeah, seriously, where the fuck did the ball go? He got it just before. Set the screen, Kato. God damn, you suck at this thing, Kato.
Out to the right wing. Here's Watts.
Bro, we cannot get a shot up right now.
D right on him. And the dunk by Porzingis.
And bringing the aggression and the energy.
Okay, Porzingis is the guy they needed to pair with fucking Halliburton. But did they really have to trade me away to do it? Like, they couldn't have just made it like a big four, me, Maxi, and Halliburton. And then with Porzingis, like.
Here's Maxi. Rebounded by the Celtics. Anunoby's got his fourth rebound with that last one here tonight. Watts.
We finally made something. Oh my god.
He's got 15.
Yeah, he was able to sneak it to the rim. Had enough room to get just like an easy layup.
How is that not a steal? My god. Oh my god.
He was solid in the first half from deep. He's a guy who can get hot. Let's see how he does here in the second.
Stop dribbling in the same place. You get nowhere doing that. That's not stolen again. Okay.
Lead pass was put in just the right spot.
His accuracy is on another level this quarter. Really high quality
shot. I love how when I set them the screen, they go past it, but then they do a dribble right back to it, to the spot we were just at.
And Boston with the rebound.
Like,
got 11 rebounds in the game.
It don't make sense.
Here's Brown. Basket number six,
like, if you made a dribble move to go back, then I would understand and actually, like, curl around and drive. But they just stay in the same spot. They don't move.
Maxi against MP. Step back shot. And again, it's Indiana.
Capitalizing from the mid-range. Maxi just taking what he sees and making it available.
See, set the screen. Dribbles right back to where we just were.
He kicks it to MP. Back to Brown.
Okay, actually, fucking dribble. Brown, you bastard!
7 for 11 from the floor.
Another bucket down low. They've been the aggressors, taking the ball inside and attacking at the rim.
Now here's Maxi.
Bro, I can't do anything against him.
Waiting for him to miss when he's that open. You're going to be in for a long
Okay, Jaylen Brown, you know how a screen works, buddy. Fucking hell, dude.
Mathurin against Brown, passes it to Watts. And there are the Celtics with another basket.
Not just being selfless, but also smart with the ball. Brown is able to find the best guy for the right shot.
Halliburton outside. And there's the pass to Mathurin. 5 to shoot. He gets that one. Mathurin's got 10.
Oi, oi, oi.
How good is that? I mean, he can make a defender look foolish at times.
Okay, Watts, let's see how you do with the screen.
Kicks it
practically the same damn thing.
Pass to Watts. Back to Kaminsky. And there's the block. Just stops it cold and takes possession. Here's Maxi. And 2 free throws coming up. Unable to get that one to go with all the content.
The thing you love about Maxi is that he always has a smile when he's out there. He's enjoying himself. And he embraces the challenge that the game presents.
And what do you guys think so far about the offensive approach for the Celtics?
Oh, they've been punishing the inside defense consistently in this one. Look, it's been a very productive area of the floor for them.
And another area they've separated themselves has been their three-point shooting, making the defense pay for any airspace.
And he makes the first.
I can't do anything on the inside.
Josh Christopher comes in for Benedict Mathurin.
Who the hell's Chris?
Here's Mann. He's guarded by Kaminsky.
No shot he makes that. Okay, thank God. Why would we pass it to me?
Enzo is the Boston Celtics. Cruising into the quarter break with a 22-point.
You couldn't spell Kristaps? Ferocious defense. And we'll be right back. Even if you did just shorten Chris, it's the wrong spelling of Chris. Like... even if you did K-R-I-S, I still would have no idea who the fuck that Chris would be. Then go to bed, like...
And let's take this chance now to show you the State Farm assist of the game.
If you're sleepy, go to bed. If you're tired, like...
On this pass, put it on a platter form.
You've got to admire the vision just as much as the accuracy. Not many players can even spot that pass.
Okay, fourth quarter. Here we go. Yeah, I'm the point guard. Woohoo, let's go.
...from these teams today as we get going in quarter number four. On the court for Indiana.
Hauser, you've made this work so many times before, and not now. I am not driving that in. I fucking see Porzingis right there. Now I am. There we go. KP's out in the corner. I'm good to drive.
Confidence in the world. Excellent job not being distracted by the defense.
Here's Wong. He's guarded by
Kaminsky. Give me that shit. God damn it.
And that's 2 points on the layup.
That's a blue collar.
I've already won DPOI. I won it last year.
Got a second chance to score.
Pass to Kato. The dish now to Kaminsky.
Ah.
Now here's Okoro. Tries it from nine. Again, the
lane's open. I'll take the shot. As long as KP ain't right there, I'm fine.
Three baskets.
Pacers shooting 38% from the field.
Oh, yes, cookies. And Anunoby cut.
Anunoby kicks to Kaminsky.
Damn. Damn, that would have been a good shot, too.
Porzingis has got 6 rebounds in the game. To the inside. Passes it to Wong. Takes the 13-footer.
Damn it.
And that's good for 2.
Oh yeah, I'm point guard. I gotta come back for the ball.
Open man on the perimeter and immediately
technically.
And the pass to Kata. The Celtics working the ball around now. Kicks it out to MP.
There we go. Mid-range shot, but we'll take points.
And that's now 33 points for MP.
Moving it around. 8 of their last 10 coming off assists.
How are these not steals, bro? Good block, Kata.
And so it looks like the Pacers will retain possession here.
Okay, my back to the 2. I am perfect.
Halliburton up top.
I'm there.
Maxey against MP.
How is that not a foul on my part? I fucking pushed him.
The Celtics have gone 3-4 in field goal attempts since getting things started here in the fourth. Right wing.
Come on, take the screen. Let's take the screen. Stop waiting for him. God damn it.
Alright. With how the MVP is chosen.
Yeah, Kev, I was happy with it. At the end of the day, there's always going to be at least 2 or 3 other guys that have a legitimate MVP case. So, you know, this year might have been a close one, but next year it might go to the next guy. Well, okay, well, I like
they don't. I don't understand why.
Defense was waiting on him that time.
Fucking hell, just take the screen, dude. Thank you. Holy shit. And then passes it way too damn late for an actual good shot. Drive, damn.
Here's Kaminsky.
There we go. Fuck, dude.
Kaminsky's got 11 in the second half.
Well, we've seen that movie a few times, haven't we? An easy bucket in the paint.
They've been struggling here on offense.
Yeah, that should have been a steal. Sure.
Here's Maxey.
How did you not block that, bro? Damn.
Continuing for him. The Celtics have gone 5 of 7 from the field since the beginning of the fourth. Strong work.
There we go.
And the basket by Kaminsky.
Gotta get points some way.
See them starting to really work the ball.
How many threes have we shot? 7 for 8. Okay.
For Indiana, they've gone 2 of 7 from the field in what's been a cold start to the fourth quarter for them. Here's Mathurin. That shot, no good. Some solid defense.
I think I just need to build more team chemistry, and then they'll actually start making things work. But what was that? Why did we go back towards defenders on the pass and OG? Like,
starting to take shape here. They're working it inside and getting good shots from close range.
Now here's Porzingis. And here is Nesmith.
Good block. That's us. There we go.
So far, that's 6 blocks.
Greg protecting the rim. Love the hustle.
Okay, 7.5 minutes. Do we still have to sit? I have no idea. We have to sit. 37 points. I ain't getting my fucking shit. You know, if the teammates actually, you know, worked with me, then maybe we could actually have our regular stat line, but
both teams will make substitutions.
He's shooting that, yep. But he's missing it, okay. How the hell did I get the rebound? How did I not?
That's not gonna get it. If you don't take care of the ball, fellas, that's what can happen.
Absolutely, Greg. That makes the turnover even more painful.
We know mistakes lead to breaks. That's just textbook right there.
And here's Halliburton. He'll bring it up for Indiana. Well, players certainly have become comfortable, Richard, asking for trades. Has it become too commonplace?
It doesn't happen too much in general. I just think a lot of times it's the star.
And sometimes you get traded without even asking. You know, you want to win multiple championships on the team? Eh, they'll trade you anyway.
Two-way street. I remember Blake Griffin signing a 5-year contract with the Clippers, and then next thing you know, he was traded.
Here's Wong. Following the basket by MP.
How do you foul like that as a big man on the drive?
First free throw is good. Okoro. Oh, he's checked in for the Celtics. Porzingis, he's checked in for Indiana. Wade comes in for Halliburton.
Oh, they put Porzingis in last minute just to spite the Celtics, even though we blew him out by 27.
Down, it's obvious to everyone who watched it. Just a total mismatch and a true
make it 30, why not?
For the Celtics.
This was a team performing to its fullest capability.
A hugely satisfying win. A game that not many will soon forget. And on the other side, one that I think most will try to forget.
And it'll advance their win.
Good box out, Hauser. I'm up. Pass that
shot.
Really,
they finally got something good to happen against this team. The last two games they faced them weren't nearly as productive.
And you know, when you look at the huge impact.
That's insane. I actually made that shot.
Monster game for MP.
And he was doing everything out there on the floor tonight. Triple-double on the stat sheet, and that doesn't even tell the whole story.
And here's Wade. Following the three-pointer by MP, pass to man.
Damn it.
Christopher. And he can't answer back. The three-pointer offline. 3 seconds separate the shot clock and game clock. MP dishes to Irving.
I swear to God, how do you miss that? Oh my God.
From past the arc, buries it from three-point range.
Man. 3 points.
9 seconds left in the fourth quarter. Here's Davison. And here's MP for three.
At least we'll take 10 threes, but we don't get 50 points because our teammates don't want to pass us the ball on the screen like that.
This game wasn't handed to them.
they took it.
So
it's Boston easily grabbing this one. It was a tale of two teams tonight. One that
I'm gonna punch the GM for this for the Celtics.
Only a
52%? What the hell?
Fans involved from the get-go, and once they started to really,
wait, how the hell do we get to 45% in our first game? We only get to 52 on our second? Oh, I'm gonna, with a fuck, our GM, I'm gonna punch him. And hey, we moved up a spot. There we go. Sam Olson, I got a right hook knuckle sandwich with your name on it, buddy. Cause holy shit. Does Mason Miller deserve one too? He's the scout. I feel like he should deserve one too. Yeah, I got a left hook knuckle sandwich with his name on it. Maybe Owen Masters might give him a kick to the balls. Why did they trade me away, man? Well, the Pacers finally got their first loss of the season. Courtesy of yours truly. But yeah. We're still sitting with single digit losses, 12-9. Oh, they're absolutely going to make it to the playoffs with Haliburton, Maxey's in the starting lineup, and Kristaps Porzingis. And I gave them a 20-game head start. I'm pretty sure if I go back to one of my VODs and I see their records, I think the 8th seed was like 40, had 40 wins. I think 50 wins was the most wins we faced with somebody. So, like, all they need to do is win 30 by themselves, and they're in the playoffs. If they somehow manage to tank and just completely obliterate their chances at playoffs, that would be really funny to see. It's going to be interesting to see how far they drop, because I have the challenge of seeing how far I can bring the Celtics up. Let's see. Where are we currently sitting? We're sitting 5th in the East. So yeah. Pacers obviously top seed. Yeah. Let's see, go team stats again. Yeah. See, how many games are we behind them? Games played. I don't know how many. I don't know where I would see that. I don't know where I would see, like, games back. Last 30 days, last 5 games. Let's see. We're probably like 8-ish games behind. So if they lose 8 games and we could win 8 games straight, we should easily catch up to them, but that's probably not going to happen because they are 1-1 without me. I'm going to check real quick and see if we play them one more time. Because God, I hope we do. Because that's going to help us. Okay, we play them one more time in March. After the All-Star break. So, we're definitely going to be... Hopefully, we're going to be good enough to just absolutely cruise through January and February. And March is just going to be an absolute clown house for everybody else. Now, the question is, once we do get done with regular season, where will the Pacers end up postseason? That's going to be a good question. But yeah, that is down the road. But that's gonna do it. Unfortunately, I'm gonna have to struggle a hell of a lot more games with this team until we get where I want to be, but oh well. But yeah, anyways, like the screen says, thank you all so much for watching. Anybody in the future, thank you for that. Hope y'all enjoyed. If you could, would very much appreciate it. Drop a follow / subscribe to the socials down below. Follow over here on Twitch and then over on X. Then go ahead and subscribe over on YouTube. That's all I got for now for socials. And it's also the simplest way to support me. Just gotta click a few buttons here and there. So, yeah. Don't think there should be anything else. Yeah. Alright. Anyways, as always, until next time. Deuces.